Welcome to another video in Python series. In our last video, we made a very simple program in which we added two numbers by assigning them to two variables A and B. So in this video, we are going to learn more about assignment of variables, and let's see the two methods in which you can assign the variables. The first is each variables go in a separate line. Like we have three assignments here, maths, English and computer, and we have assigned them the value 75, 88 and 90, and we are going to print all of them. Okay, so this is first method. In the second method, you can see that we have used just single line to assign all the three variables. Okay, first maths, comma English and comma computer, we separate them with comma, and the values also go by comma separation, and they have to be in the same sequence, like 75 for maths, English 88 and computer 90. So both of them will give you the same result, and that is the reason I have two print commands, and you can see the output. Let's run the program again, and as you can see, we are getting the same result. So this is how you can assign variables in Python. You can have them in a same line, or you can keep them in a separate line. And it also works for strings. Okay, so for example, you have grades in computer. Say you got grade A, and because it is a string, it has to be in quotation. Okay, so in the second method, we have used grade for computer. Let's run the program. And as you can see, we are getting A in the output. Now with this change in the marks, like we have changed from integer to a string, you must have noticed that even though the variable name is same, we are getting a different output. There is no error, nothing like that. Like first we are defining computer as an integer value, then we are defining computer as a string value. So in Python, these variables are dynamic. We call it as a dynamic typing feature, in which you can assign different kind of literals to the same variable. Like here, the computer can be integer, and after a few lines you can define it as a string. There will be no problem, no error, nothing, and the value in the variable will be changed accordingly. And finally, let us learn how the user can input values to the variable, because right now we are just hard coding the values in our program. We are feeding the values in our program itself, and they cannot be changed at the runtime. Okay, but so what if we want the user to enter these values? Your user should enter the marks of maths, English and computer. So how we can do that? So let's see. Let's use the same variables, maths, English and computer. Maths equal to input. So now we are using the input function. Instead of giving the value here, we are using input function. And when the program will execute this line, it will ask the user to enter the value of maths. Okay, let's do the same for other subjects. Equal to input. Computer is equal to input. Okay, let's run this program, and because we have two print commands here, the first line and the second line, we are getting the two output, and the cursor is blinking. It is asking you to enter some values for this math subject. So let us give marks here, say 87. Again, we have two more subjects. Next we have English. It is asking for the marks of English, let's say 98, and finally the computer, 78. Okay, because we have no print command, nothing happened, the program ended. Let's copy and paste this print command so that we have something in the output once we have entered the values. Let's save and run the program again. and the program is waiting for user input. Let's say 97, 79, and 99. So now we have the output from this print line, 98, 79, 99. These were the marks we have entered. But one thing here, you must have seen that the cursor is waiting for user input and there is no indication what the user have to actually enter, because we are writing the program. That is another thing, that we know that what the user is supposed to enter, but if the user is new, he doesn't know, then it will be a problem. Just a blank cursor waiting for input is not good. We should tell the user what he has to enter. So we can do that. We can write that inside this parenthesis. Let's say enter marks of maths. You can use both single and double quotations. Okay, both of them will work. English, computer. Let's run our program again. We are getting these two outputs from these two print commands, and here we have our first input, enter marks of maths. 85 marks of English, 97 and 95, and we are getting the output. So you have learned the two methods of assigning the variables. You have also learned that you can make the program ask the user for the input, and you have also learned that we have dynamic typing, in which the values can be changed from string to integer or integer to string anytime in the program. So that is all for this video. Hope you have enjoyed learning. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.